This is the Catholic Daily Journal for Monday, May the 20th, 2019. Today in AD 325, the First Council of Nicaea formally opened. It would be the first ecumenical council of the Catholic Church. Now, a few things. Ecumenical means worldwide. The modern usage of the word ecumenism and ecumenical is a hot mess, and so we won't get into it here. A council is a formal meeting of bishops of the church to address a specific agenda of items, almost always specific threats to the good order and the teaching of the church. The first real ecumenical council was held in the city of Nicaea in what is now Turkey. There were four big items on the agenda. Number one was the question of what it means for Jesus to be the Son of God. How is he related to God the Father? Is his nature as God separate from his nature as man? Is he truly God or truly man or both or neither? Is he an amalgam? It's a pretty big question. Number two on the agenda was the drafting of a creed, which would be a bit more complete than the Apostles' Creed, which had been in use since the mid-80s or so AD. Number three on the agenda was the date of Easter. There was disagreement about whether it should be calculated from the lunar calendar the way the Jews did it, or should there be another method. Number four was to determine exactly how to publish or promulgate the law and the decisions made by the church, the pope, the councils, and so on. The bishops met from May through August and included about 300 Eastern bishops and five Western bishops. Well, today in 1873, Jacob Davis and Levi Strauss officially received the patent for their new type of men's pants, which used a heavy-duty material called denim and a series of copper rivets to make the pants strong and long-lasting. Davis was the tailor who created the design and the implementation. Strauss was the money and the businessman. It's worth noting that neither Davis nor Strauss invented blue jeans. That phrase goes way back and included overalls and even coats at various times. The same with the use of heavy-duty materials. Denim cloth and dungaree cloth had been around for a while. The big innovation that Davis and Strauss brought to the table was the little copper rivets. They increased the life of the pants substantially and added a sense of technological innovation and modernity at a time when the Industrial Revolution was creating new wealth everywhere. Even laborers and factory workers could think about a better life. Strauss turned that thinking into a phenomenon. Around the same time, in 1875 today, the Meter Convention was signed by 17 nations. It was also called the Treaty of the Meter, and it was an international treaty that created the International Bureau of Weights and Measures, which established to a high degree of precision the exact measure of the so-called SI base units, the meter, the kilogram, the second, the ampere, the degree Kelvin, the mole, and the candela. The two big challenges were the meter and the kilogram, which were physically produced in the form of a stick and a block, and given to each country to take home. In 2019, the SI base units were redefined so as not to be based on any physical measure. The meter, for example, was defined as 1/10,000,000th of the distance from the Earth's equator to the North Pole measured on the circumference through Paris. That's not the easiest thing to measure. Now, though, it's the length of the path traveled by light in a vacuum during a time interval of 1/299,792,458 of a second, which is much better. Finally, today, in a moment of sad but necessary remembrance, the former army base turned forced labor camp at Oswiecim, Poland, processed its first new prisoners. The camp was renamed Auschwitz. It would operate for just under 5 years. And an estimated 1.6 million people died in its custody. Lord have mercy on them. The Catholic Daily Journal is supported by listeners like you. For more information, visit CatholicUnderground.com. And until next time, be on the lookout for the Lord at work in your life.